There are a million actresses who have appeared on the silver screens with amazing performances, but only a few are worthy of remembrance, long after they have passed on. Our golden girl for today is the beautiful Annette Vadim, whose life and career is definitely worth revisiting. But before we go on, hit the subscribe button and comment "I subscribed" in the comment section below and get a personal shout out from us. All set? Buckle up and get ready for this blast from the past. Early life. Born Annette Stroyberg on December 7th, 1936, in the village of Rinkeby, Kirkmind Municipality, Denmark. She grew up on the island of Finn, the third largest island in Denmark, but lost her father, who was a physician, at a very tender age. So she and her sister moved to Copenhagen, the capital city of Denmark, where they were raised. Did you know she was related to the renowned Danish actress Camilla Soberg? It turns out she was the cousin of Camilla's mother. Needless to say, this is definitely where she got her acting genes from. Aside the death of her father, Annette had a really uneventful childhood, but was considered to be a typical Sagittarius, a natural leader, playful but enthusiastic about whatever she set her mind to. We consider her childhood a really fun ride, and she had a very close connection with her sister, Mirette Stroyberg. You wouldn't expect less. They were all they had. They were practically best friends and did everything together. Career. While in her late teens, Annette Stroyberg moved to the French capital, Paris, in search of a means of livelihood. Due to the fact that she didn't have an extensive educational background, she had to use other attributes that she had to find work. For example, her beauty. And boy, was she beautiful. Danish women are known for their flaming red hair and sensual beauty. And Annette got a full share of this, with a lot of extras. She had the charm of a kitten that made everyone she met to warm up towards her instantly. All this combined with her amazing slim physique made her one of the most sought after women in modeling industry. And before long, she landed her first modeling gig. Her stunning beauty was put to good use by couture houses who used her as the face of their products. A move that not only increased their sales greatly, but also earned her widespread recognition, in her country at least. In the early 1950s, she also appeared as a cover girl in an advertisement for Tuborg Beer, a Danish brewing company. And no, she did not have an alcohol problem, just a young girl trying to get by. She worked with the couture houses for a while before catching the eye of the big players like Chanel. Her employment with them was one of the highlights of her career, and it opened doors to the world of acting. Propelled by her newfound fame and confidence, coupled with her beauty, she landed a role in the film Dangerous Liaisons, a French film, based on the epistolary novel written by Pierre Chauderlot de Laclos in 1782. The film was set in present-day France and was directed by Roger Vadim, who later became her husband. She starred alongside Jeanne Moreau and Gérard Philippe, who were world-class actors at the time, and she was understandably intimidated by their excellent performance. Not that she put up a totally awful appearance, she was actually stunning, but the performance of an amateur making a debut cannot be compared to the performance of established actors with hours of screen time under their belt. She was simply outclassed by them. She performed better in the exploitive Blood and Roses, that was directed by Roger Vadim still and released in 1960. Although she gained more recognition with the movie, the doors of acting were practically shut in her face because of her marriage to Vadim, which was her ticket to big time roles, had failed. She subsequently moved to Italy, where she appeared in a few small time movies like The Snatching before she finally gave up on acting and closed that chapter. Personal life. Annette's beauty was irresistible to anyone who came across her, and this landed her in four marriages and several other affairs. It was almost like the minute she left one man, another man was ready to scoop her up without delay. Only ice cream can be that irresistible. Her first marriage was to Roger Vadim, whom she met on the set of Dangerous Liaisons, and immediately fell in love with. He was fresh out of a marriage to the beautiful Brigitte Bardot, and was looking for young love too. He tried turning her into a star by casting her in huge roles, a little too huge for her budding career. When that fell through, pretty much the entire marriage did too, and she ran off with Brigitte's former lover, Sacha Distel. She was married to Vadim from 1958 to 1961, and they had a child together, Natalie Vadim. She reportedly had affairs with Vittorio Gassman, Alain Delon, Omar Sharif, and Warren Beatty. In 1967, she married Guy Sanouf, a French-Moroccan sugar king, with whom she had one son, Yann, born in 1967. This marriage, like her first, didn't last so long, and in 1974 she married Gregory Kalimanpoulos, a Greek shipping magnate, and born him yet another son, Perisiles Kalimanopoulos. In the same year she got married to him. She settled with her new family in America for a while, but this marriage ended too, so she had to move back to Europe and lived in Paris and Copenhagen. Her final marriage was to a lawyer, Christian Lelonde, in 2001. They were together until her death in 2005. Annette passed on in December 2005 from cancer. At the time of her death, estimates placed her net worth to be around $1 million. And that ends our remembrance of the actress Annette Vadim. Although I think she fared better as a model than as an actress, what do you think? Give us your thoughts in the comments section below and tell us how much you enjoyed this video. Do not forget to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't, so you do not miss out on premium content from us. See you next time! Thank you.